The Nuestro America, as you know, was constructed as seeing the commonality in the Americas by not sort of emphasizing the differences and the dividing forces, but also suggesting a level of solidarity, of understanding. And here we can establish an environment where the discussions are not just contained within the classroom. There's a spillover in discussions, in the cafe, in the cafeteria, during dinner, during the lectures. There's an interaction that could not happen within a European university setting. And very often we have sort of established notions of working with the others that are actually based on concepts that also have to be challenged. For example, if we look at from Europe to the US, we look at it, or Europe to Canada, Europe, Latin America, we look at it in terms of colonial past experience, disregarding the interrelatedness of a West Hemisphere approach of inter-American studies, and therefore by looking at it not only from a European to an inter-American studies perspective, we're already not only looking at specific details, but also challenging the concepts that are behind European-American relationships. I think that everyone that works interdisciplinarity has to have a strength in one field, has to sort of know about the theories and backgrounds and contents of one approach, and then can have be open towards that. So it's important to get different people together. And here at the summer school, we have tried not only to get people together from different regional backgrounds, working on different regional aspects, and from different disciplines. So on the looking at the Americas is an additional challenge, because we're not just looking at it from one specific field. We're not just looking at the literatures of the Americas or films of the Americas or politics of the Americas. We're trying to both have a very vast regional component and an interdisciplinary approach. So there are two aspects of challenges that we face. And of course, we have to be careful that we don't spread ourselves too thin, that we only sort of scratch the surface and don't do proper scholarly work. Well, I climb the seven summits. And form and content go together. They're part of each other. We can't talk about the content without the form, and the form without the content. This is also something, of course, that post-structuralism has shown us in much more radical terms than before. But in that sense, it's a moot question, I think, because America, whether an empty signifier or a content signifier, is a signifier. And it stands for something. And we refer to America in many different aspects. On the one hand, as a metaphor. Already in the 19th century in German language literature, America stood for many aspects without having an understanding perhaps of what the real America is. We have set this summer school on the topic of the Americas. There are other summer schools that are taking place that are looking at other parts of the world in connection with Europe. As Europeans, we have to take on this task also of looking beyond Europe. On the one hand, to define our own European identity, but also to see ourselves that Europe is not the center of the world, it is one continent within the world, and that we have to interact. I cannot see. Well, I sang to myself that I want to be free, but the road I must travel, its end I cannot see. Na, 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 na.
desert and was burned in the heat. But the road I must travel, its end I cannot see. Well, I crossed the frozen wasteland, in the bitter cold did freeze. And the road I must travel, its end I cannot see. And I will knock on every door, for I do not have a key. And the road I must travel, its end I cannot see. Well, I sang to myself that I wanna be free. But the road I must travel, its end I cannot see. Soho, couldn't guess his age. I found his empty journal. I filled up every